Every spring, yellow-billed loons make an incredible journey from the coastal waters of Asia, southern Alaska, and British Columbia to the pristine tundra wetlands of the North American Arctic. The sparkling freshwater lakes scattered across northern Alaska and Canada are teeming with fish and provide a perfect haven for nesting and rearing chicks. But migration is a dangerous undertaking. Threats loom along migration routes and on both wintering and nesting areas for this international species of concern. While the North American population of loons has remained stable in the past, there are some new threats that could pose issues in the future. It's springtime in the Yellow Sea. Pairs of loons are embellished with black and white checkered breeding plumage as they prepare for their long flight to the Arctic. Loons forage in both marine and freshwater environments. Alaska and Canada, with extensive coastline and tundra habitats, provide access to both. Despite their graceful movements on water, these large-bodied divers are slow and clumsy on land. Their powerful webbed feet propel them through the water with ease, but are not well adapted for walking on the tundra. For this reason, they prefer very large, deep bodies of water with sturdy, grassy shores to build their nests and stay protected from predators. These ideal nesting spots are limited. All species of loons engage in intense competition on breeding lakes. Yellow-billed loons are fierce defenders and will use their sharp, dagger-like bills to chase, wound, and even kill their opponents. Once a breeding territory is established, pairs of loons return faithfully year after year to defend and breed on their lake once again. A particular lake may be occupied by the same pair of loons for over a decade, as these loons begin breeding at 4 to 7 years old and may live to be 20 years old or more. Although, devotion to their breeding grounds comes at a cost. The reluctance to search for new lake locations reduces the likelihood of an adult Alaskan loon to ever mate with a loon from another population. Because these loons don't often interbreed, the variability in the gene pool remains low, and the population can be at a greater risk when exposed to environmental challenges. Over the course of the summer, pairs of yellow-billed loons will devote all of their energy to protecting, feeding, and rearing their young. One or two brown speckled eggs are laid, and after about 28 days, dark fuzzy chicks emerge. Loon chicks depend heavily on their parents for the first few weeks of their lives. Each adult takes turns foraging for fish and aggressively guarding their precious offspring. For many years, these productive lakes have provided sanctuary for the yellow-billed loons while they raise their young. But as the climate continues to warm, permafrost beneath the tundra is thawing rapidly, leading to the sudden drainage of valuable nesting lakes. While some drying and reforming of lakes is normal, larger lakes are draining completely and much faster than in the past. Along with the threats of habitat loss on their breeding grounds, loons may be exposed to high concentrations of environmental contaminants that collect within freshwater bodies. Contaminants, such as methylmercury, increase in concentration at each step of the food web. Since loons are top predators in their aquatic ecosystem, they can end up with the highest levels of mercury poisoning. The air is getting colder and days are getting shorter as yellow-billed loons once again prepare to make the grand journey south. The stunning checkered pattern worn by adults will transform into a drab gray and white plumage. Most loons nesting in Alaska follow the coast south and then head west to their wintering areas near northern Japan and the Yellow Sea. During their migration, loons come in contact with large fishing vessels and many end up as accidental bycatch in fishing nets. Canadian nesting loons set themselves apart by following a primarily overland route to their wintering areas on the southern coast of Alaska and British Columbia. Very little is known about loon behavior during winter months. Up until recently, even their migration routes were unclear. Several studies have now used satellite telemetry to map their routes, a technique in which the loons are implanted with a satellite transmitter to track their movements over the year. Little data exists on the life history of immature and non-breeding birds, but they are thought to remain in marine habitats during the summer breeding season. Sadly, not all wintering areas provide safety from environmental contaminants. In fact, the potential for exposure is greater due to the increased pollution and closer proximity to human infrastructure in these densely populated regions of the globe. As sea ice declines across polar regions, vessel traffic in the Bering Strait and both Bering and Chukchi Seas continues to rise and increase the likelihood of industrial spills. Over a lifetime, exposure to global contaminants at breeding and wintering areas can threaten the health of these long-lived birds. Alaska is home to the entire U.S. breeding population of this international species of concern. Only about 3,000 birds nest in Alaska. For perspective, the smallest NFL stadium in the U.S. can seat 60,000 people. About 500 birds nest on and around the Seward Peninsula, an area with two national park lands, Bering Landbridge National Preserve and Cape Krusenstern National Monument. Loons that persistently return to these nesting areas are protected under the Alaska National Interest Lands Conservation Act. However, the greater proportion of Alaska's population of loons breeds in the National Petroleum Reserve Alaska, an area slated for oil and gas development. Increasing human activity around breeding and wintering grounds, perpetual change in the Arctic landscape, and extremely low crossover of populations constantly put the yellow-billed loon's adaptive capabilities to the test. Threats loom on the horizon for the magnificent yellow-billed loon, a rare beauty of remote northern oceans and tundra wetlands. Though they are incredibly resilient, are they tough enough to survive an uncertain future?